Welcome back, everyone. To start, let me ask, in your experience, what's the first question a young child might ask about their origins, and when might they ask it?
My 4-year-old asked me one day, totally out of the blue, where do babies come from? I was shocked. Funny, but mine asked it 4 also. Only she was much more personal and sassy about it. Wanted to know exactly where she came from. I was like, I don't think so.
Okay, if I'm hearing you correctly, you both were thinking this was a question about sex. But if we consider the question from the child's point of view, we'll discover that where did I come from is really a question about a child's relationship with space and time in the world, and has nothing to do with sex.
I don't know. That sounds a little heavy for Tim. He mostly thinks about sounds that come out his butt.
Cute. But hear me out, Terry. Around 4 years old, children's brains make some important leaps in development, and they start to understand basic space-time concepts that used to be totally above their heads. For example, words like here, there, before, now, and phrases like after dinner and before you were born. This can spark some interesting new ideas, like, last night, Daddy told me I wasn't in that picture of him and Mommy in the dining room because it was taken before I was born. I think I know what he meant. I am here now in our family, so I'm thinking there must have been a time when I wasn't here. I think I'll go ask Dad where I was before I was here. So, where did I come from isn't about sex. It's about time, space, and location. That's why it starts with the word where.
I get it. Plus, I think I had that same conversation in college one night.
So what should we say when they ask?
Well, it's a where question, so try a where answer. Something like, you know that everyone starts out as a baby, right? Well, before babies are born, they grow inside their biological mom's body in a special place called a uterus or womb.
Isn't uterus a word that's way too grown up for such a little kid?
See, there's that double standard thinking again. You wouldn't hesitate to say kidney or stomach in front of a kid that age, right? Anyway, 4-year-olds are pretty matter-of-fact about bodies, so they'll probably respond with something like, okay, thanks for the cool new word. What's for lunch?
Oh, man. What's next? The stork?
That's actually pretty close. Most children are satisfied for quite a while just knowing about uteruses and might not ask about their origins again until they're 5 or so. Want to guess what they usually ask then?
Well, if they know they used to be in the womb and now they're not, maybe they'd want to know how they got out of there.
Right on, Fiona. Around age 5, kids start thinking about another new concept, the idea of how things move through time and space. That's why they suddenly love playing with cars, trucks, and clocks. So we shouldn't be at all surprised if one day they ask, I know babies come from a special place inside the body, but how exactly do they get out of there and move out here? The piece of information they're missing is that there's a connecting space between the inside of the uterus and the outside world. So, it's a great time to teach them the word vagina.
And I thought uterus was hard.
Well, remember, to them, understanding the purpose of vaginas during the birth process is like understanding a tunnel that connects one place to another.
It really makes sense. This is all about kids figuring out how things work in the world. They don't know anything about sexual intercourse yet, so why would they ask about it?
Yes, that's right. Great job, everyone. And now that we talked about how they got out of the uterus, next time we'll discuss the very logical follow-up question. But how did I get in there in the first place?
But I'm still getting comfortable with uterus.